Well, hello there again, my YouTube friends. This is just a quick video today on this Hoover that I've been repairing. It's a Bosch Athlete Hoover, and the problem with it was initially the other day the brush stopped going round at the bottom. Now I took it all apart, and the problem with this particular thing, I'll zoom in a little bit, was that the motor wiring had sheared off or been cut down at the bottom here, but that's understandable over time with the amount of flexing that goes on down here. Now it's been replaced once before. It's probably just a not a very good design really. It's basically just got a cut out in this trunk in here, and the wire runs down the side to the motor, and it's continually flexing when you this is going that sort of direction. Anyway, took it apart, the wires had sheared, and basically, I made another loom that goes from this. I don't know whether you'll be able to see down there, but there's two. Can you see down there? There's two connectors down there which fit onto the bottom. I just brought it back in here actually, just so I can put it back together after I repair it. That goes on there, like so, and there's different attachments that fit on the end of it. So that's what the problem with that was. I fixed that, but then I noticed the brush still wasn't going round, which was a bit of a pain. But thinking about it, I was thinking, if it stopped going round because those wires have shorted, it could be something else further up, which it was. So I followed the wires up the Hoover. Eventually, it goes in here. Also, for anyone who's got this problem, this is why I'm making this video. The front panel that fits on like that is difficult, to say the least, to get off. So if anyone comes across this problem, you don't have to undo the screws in the bottom to get this off. All you have to do is undo these screws, which there's six of them. So you undo them, and then you'll notice that this red part will start to lift up, but it won't come out. Now, what's holding it in is this sort of secondary molding, and the secondary molding acts as a release somehow for the clips. So I ended up sort of forcing it, forcing it, forcing it like that. And then if you get a, I haven't actually got a, yes, I have. I used a guitar pick just to lift that up. Lift that up like that. So this is how you do it. If anyone there in internet land is stuck with the same sort of problem, force that up as much as you can without breaking any clips. Then pull this up as much as you can as well, the silver part. When everything's pulled as tight as you can get it, then push the silver bit back down and push it against the red, sort of like a lever. It's as if this section acts as a lever on, once you've got it, a bit of pressure on it, it acts as a lever or a release on these clips, and that's what now allows the front to come off. It just popped off eventually once I've done that. So just to recap, I'm only doing this because it took me like half an hour to figure out how it came off. Pull that as far as you can get it, this one as far as you can get it, and then when you've got both of them, pretty much good tension on them, push that back down all the way along, and you'll find it'll release the top bit. That's how this one came apart. Anyway, you don't need to take this chrome piece off, which I attempted to do. Luckily, I didn't break any clips on it or anything. Okay, so the main problem was, I don't need to get me a meter really, because I'll just show you guys what the actual problem was. It wasn't a serious issue. Can you see? You can now, I think. Okay, so what we're looking at, these two wires go down to the bottom of the Hoover down here, down the back. And we've got a little fuse, well, two little fuses actually, but you can see that one is actually blown. So it's opened, that one. So then that's the one that feeds the power down to the bottom of the Hoover. So what we need to do is replace this little fella, and I've got some here. I got them from RS, the part numbers there. These are slow blow fuses. These are the ones I picked. It's the same 5T 5 amp fuse, so should be okay. Okay, so to carry out the actual task, I've moved over here to the bench. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a bit of flux first and just put a bit on this old fuse just to help transfer the heat down to the pads. And then I'm going to get these tweezers and then see if I can get enough heat through this fuse to take it off. The tips are really small on these tweezers. I'm not actually sure if they'll work. No, it's going to need the bigger tips, I think. It's this type I'm going to put in. Slightly larger ones. Well, hugely larger compared to the previous type. And yeah. Okay, so he came off eventually. Okay, so these are the fuses again. RS part number 769-3744. And we'll do a proper job and just clean it up. This is just a bit of IPA. You could do this with an iron if you were very careful, just doing one side at a time. Tweezers or two irons is much preferred, or even heat, you know, hot air. But the problem with hot air is you're going to start melting or burning this celastic coating, so I really wanted to try and avoid that. Fresh solder with some flux on here. And come in a little bit further, I think. I've got this sort of balanced because it's a round shape. It's a bit of a pain to try and keep in the correct position so you guys can see. So let's just put a bit of solder on there. And now we'll switch back to the tweezers. And that will do. It's not perfectly straight, but it's soldered on. Okay, so that's about that, and we'll just give it a clean up. Before we progress any further, I'm just going to test that we've got continuity across there now. Okay, so that's okay. That's just in case, you know, handling the fuse or treating it with heat or handling it with heat, you know, it hasn't blown or something like that. So it's always worth checking so that you don't have to do it again. Okay, let's see if this works, shall we? Just before I assemble the whole thing, I'm just going to put this together basically so that I can get the top back on, because if I don't put this bit back on just to regain the shape of the neck, I can't get the control handle back on. So it's better if I just do this. Ready for some noise, guys? Watch it if you've got headphones on. Okay, and then speed two. Okay, that was the problem. Okay, guys, that's it. Anyone has problems with the Bosch Applet Hoover, that's the problem. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching, and I shall see you in the next video. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.